Hi there. So today's video is 20 important verses or 20 verses that I know, 20 verses that have helped me in my 20 years. Okay, maybe not 20 years, but 20 verses that have helped me across the years. And they're in no particular order. I've just written down the verses, not the, how do I say it? Like, I've just written down the names of the verses, but not the verses themselves, because I'm going to try and say them from my head, or from my head knowledge. And the funny thing about it is, when I thought about this video, I was like, oh, that would be a good video to make, but I didn't think I actually knew 20 verses off my head. So then I just decided to take a piece of paper and like jot down all the verses that I know, or the names of all the verses that I know. And to my surprise, I was like, oh wait, I actually know more than 20 verses off my head. So that's kind of how this video came along. And if I make mistakes, then don't kill me, I'm only human, but I'm going to try my best to say them exactly as they're found in the Bible. And yeah, I hope you enjoy. The first one is Philippians 4 verse 13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. The second one is Romans 8 verse 28, which says, for we know that God works all things together for the good of those who love him and who are called according to his purposes. The third one is Psalm 37 verse 4, which says, delight yourself in the Lord and he will grant you the desires of your heart. The fourth one is Hebrews 4 verse 12. And the awesome thing about this is we actually did a series on this verse on this channel. So if you haven't watched the series on the Word of God, then go ahead and watch it, because it was a really awesome series. And I remember just, I think either yesterday or earlier today, I think it was yesterday though, I randomly decided to watch one of the videos from that series. And I was like, wait, what? Was that really me speaking? And I was like, definitely not. It was totally the Holy Spirit speaking through me, because I just couldn't believe the amazing things that were coming out of my mouth in that video. So yeah, it just helped me a lot just watching it again. And yeah, I believe there's just so much revelation in that series. So go ahead and watch it if you haven't watched it. So yeah, Hebrews 4 verse 12 says, the word of God is living and active, and it is sharper than any double-edged sword, piercing even to the division of soul and spirit, joint and marrow, and it discerns the thoughts and the intentions of the heart. The next one is Hebrews 13 verse 8, which says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And then the next one, I feel like everybody knows this verse. Okay, maybe not everybody, but I feel like as long as you went to Sunday school, you most likely had to memorize this verse. It's John 3 verse 16, and it's just like the foundation of our Christianity. So feel free to say it along with me, because as I said, I feel like everyone knows this verse. Okay, John 3 verse 16. For God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have eternal life. And then number 7 is Proverbs 4 verse 23. Guard your heart with all diligence, for from out of it flow the issues of life. The next one is Romans 1 verse 16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, first to the Jew and then also to the Greek. And then number 9, 1 Peter 1 verse 14 to 16. As obedient children, do not be conformed to the passions of your former ignorance. First Peter 1 verse 14 to 16. As obedient children, do not be conformed to the passions of your former ignorance, but instead be holy as he who called you is holy, be holy in all your conduct. As since it is written, you shall be holy as I am holy. I don't know why I messed up so much on that one, but as I said, I'm only human. The next one is Proverbs 3 verse 5 to 6, which says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him and he will make your path straight. I think that's such a beautiful verse. Next one is Jeremiah 29 verse 11. And again, I feel like this is such a popular verse. It says, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. And then number 12, Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1. There is a time and a season for everything under heaven. And then number 13, Joshua 1 verse 8. Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night. In doing so, you shall make your path prosperous and your way successful. And then number 14, Galatians 5 verse 22 to 23, again quite a popular one. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Above such there is no law. And then 15, Ephesians 3, 20. Now to him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. I think the 21 part of it says, I didn't memorize this, but I'm just going to try. So I might be a little bit off because I don't know it by head. But it says, be all glory and power and honor for all generations, I think, or something like that. But yeah, the 20 part of it is the one that I'm familiar with. And then the 16th one is Job 42:10. This is one of my most favorite scriptures in the Bible. Just because there was a certain time in my life where I memorized it and it really helped me. It says, and the Lord restored to Job all his losses after he prayed for his friends. And then 1 Peter 2 verse 9 says, for you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own special people, called by him who... Sorry, messed up a little bit there again. 1 Peter 2 verse 9. For you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own special people called by him, who called God's own special people called out of the kingdom of darkness into this glorious light. Finally got it. And then Zechariah 4 verse 10, which I don't know the full verse, but it basically says, do not despise the days of humble beginnings. And then number 19, Genesis 1 verse 27, God created man in his own image, male and female, he created them. And then the last one, number 20, is Matthew 6 verse 33, which says, seek you first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So yeah, those are my 20 verses. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you were able to say some of them along with me. And yeah, I hope you can study these verses and maybe they'll help you out at some point in your life as well. Bye, and God bless you.